Chairperson, Professor Kunu, Professor Lakshman Rao, and distinguished guest. This is a basically a programming oriented paper. I will not go to the detail. You will find it in the page 444 of the conference volume, my paper. Just I highlight some few points. You stick here. I will show the programming part here. Otherwise, I will go through short details. Why knowledge management and knowledge organization necessary? I should say it is extremely necessary in this virtual environment and internet era, where billions of information is available through the net, including full text. And this knowledge organization part, the most complex and most complicated part is the ritual part, because to keep a balance between the proper recall and precision value is extremely, extremely difficult. And the scenario has become much more difficult, much more complex in the area of some interdisciplinary and multidisciplinary areas in science and technology. The areas have emerged for the last 10 to 12 years. The highlighted areas we can say it is bioinformatics, it's computational biology, it's molecular biology, it's molecular physics, biophysics, and biotechnology. So, considering all these aspects, I have taken the part of the human potential. Just a few words I will say about the human potential, because today in the current field research of molecular biology and drug design, it has found that many, many important diseases like cancer, like some hereditary diseases, some genetically syndrome, anemias, and some neurological diseases, for Alzheimer's disease and Parkinson's disease. I have taken the case of Alzheimer's and Parkinson's here. It has been detected that the changes in the molecular potential has come long before the manifestation of the disease. So, it has been taken care that the very potential sequence that has been suggested by and derived by the International Standard in Molecular Biology, it is an embedded knowledge bit. Within that very protein sequence, the potential monocyte sequence itself are knowledge-based base. So considering that base, and we have taken that potential base as a metadata. So I don't want to go to the detail of the SCOS or the semantic web, because we are quite aware about the semantic web. Why it is necessary? Because we want to arrange that metadata in an ontological, semantic, classified manner. Or you can say in a clusterous manner, which was suggested long before by Ranganathan and later by Ganesh Bhattacharya. So here the metadata are arranged in a ontological classified manner. Here in the potential sequence, example, we have taken two particular diseases, that is Alzheimer's disease and the Parkinson's disease. What are the particular potential related with that disease, manifestation of the disease, and the particular lobe of the brain has been classified in that order of the brain. That's a biological order. So, considering that it has been, it is a prototype programming model, we have tried to, first of all, the four parts of the program is that, first, we have taken all the potential sequences, and we have made a thesaurus of that potential sequence, under the, you just skip next slide, please. Because I'm not going to detail of the, please. Here, you will see that human brain, there are different parts, cerebellum, corpus callosum, frontal lobe, occipital lobe, thalamus, and the particular potential in that particular region of the brain has been taken care. Next slide. And then, the potential, this is just how the potential has been taken care from the metadata object and how the digital object were harvesting the plugging the information. Next slide. So this potential sequence has been taken as a, it is some sort of, you can say it's a cluster order, because this potential sequence, this P, for example, 12390 something with ALZ, it's a classical term of the molecular biology, and it denotes ALZ stands for Alzheimer's disease, and particular this disease which is related and relational terminal, where it is narrower or related or broader, this process has been made. Next slide. Then, this is the knowledge organization map. We have mapped this total potential of a particular Alzheimer's disease using the standard which is just like classification standard. We use those standard, and it has been documented like this. Next slide. This is the Parkinson disease for that. Next slide. And next, we have conferred or transferred this potential sequence into the XML RDF, that is Visual Descriptive Framework model program. And this model program, this is a prototype model. When you use in the internet actual environment, this model should be transferred into a web ontology language, the IOL. The IOL is not taken care here. Up to this, we have done. So this is actually very synopsis of my paper. And it is of great importance in future, next 5 to 6 years, because the drug design models, basically to diagnose some of the very important diseases, including cancer, this potential will take a leading role. Already just taken a leading role in the molecular biology and bioinformatics. So we, on the standpoint of information science people, we felt that if we can do this sort of protocol model, and if we can use this in the actual environment, then in the actual online retrieval scenario, the retrieval of by the specialist user who are working with the molecular biology or bioinformatics, the retrieval will be much more precise, the recall value and precision ratio will be well balanced. Thank you very much, sir.